Hi everyone, here we'll discuss about the fifth module, that is the business decision part 1. In this video we'll be learning about capital, the types of capital, that is fixed capital and working capital, and what are the factors affecting the working capital. So now let's get started. First, what is capital? You already must have learned what capital is, but still refreshing your knowledge. Capital refers to the saved up financial wealth, especially which used to start or maintain business. The thing is that when a business have to be started, capital is required for its establishment as well as to maintain its process. So the money required, or the land, building and the machinery required for the establishment and to maintain the business is known as a capital. So examples of capital are money, land, building, machinery, etc. This capital is required for two purposes. First is for the establishment purpose and second is for the day-to-day activities purpose. So first, coming to the establishment purpose, in order to start business we do need asset. This asset is known as the fixed asset. So first what we require is the fixed capital, that is for the purpose of establishment, and second is about to carry out the day-to-day activities. In order to carry out the day-to-day activities, working capital is required. The thing is that for the smooth functioning of the business, we do need capital on day-to-day basis. This is what working capital is about. Now, dealing into what fixed capital and working capital is in detail. Fixed capital are long-term funds which are required to create production facilities through the purchase of fixed assets, which means that fixed capital are long-term funds. It will remain throughout the business till it is being shut down. So whenever there is a business activity, fixed capital will always be there, and these are required for the purpose of create production. In order to start a production, the fixed capital is required. Examples of fixed capital are land, capital and machinery. Then fixed capital cannot be disposed without breaking up the business, which means that this fixed capital cannot be zero. Whenever there is a business activity, we can start a business activity only with a fixed capital, and only when and only a business shuts down, the fixed capital will fall to zero, else it won't fall to zero. So this is what the three important features of fixed capital is about. Now coming to the working capital. Working capital are the short-term purposes. Examples of working capital are for the purchase of raw material, payment of wages and all. And the purpose of working capital is to maintain the flow of production. In the case of fixed capital, it was required to start the production, to create production, but in the case of working capital, it is required to keep the flow of production. In order to keep the flow of production of goods and services, we need capital, that is for the purchase of raw material, to payment of labor's wages, then what is for the purchase of components and space. Then working capital is required to continue uninterrupted business operations, and also working capital is required to incur day-to-day expenses and overhead costs such as fuel, power and all. Then working capital is required to meet selling costs as such as packing, advertising, etc. So all for all these purposes, working capital is required. So for the flow or smooth functioning of the business, working capital is required. Then the need for working capital arises due to the time gap between the production and realization of cash from sales, which means that if a product is produced today and sold in the market within 5 days, the time gap between the production and sales is less. In that situation, the working capital required is less. But if the production takes place today and the sale of that same product takes place only after 1 month, the thing is that time gap between production and sales is 1 month. So when the time gap between the production and sales is too long, working capital requirements are also too long. Then the last feature of working capital is that working capital are more liquid. Working capital are more liquid is in the sense that these are more over cash based transactions. Then coming to the factors affecting working capital, first is the nature of the business. Coming to the nature of the business, we can classify it as whether it is service oriented business or whether the goods are being exchanged. If the services are being exchanged, then less of the working capital will be required. Whereas if the goods are being exchanged in the market, then the requirement for working capital will be more. It is in the sense that the case that if the goods are being exchanged, sometimes people might purchase goods on credit as well. So at that time what happens is that the producers will not get their money, isn't it? So there is a blockage in the flow of their cash return. So at that time they will face some shortage of money, and this shortage of money will be met with the help of working capital. So that's why if in the case the goods are being exchanged, we need more of the working capital rather than the services oriented business. Then coming to the length of period of manufacture. Length of period of manufacture, as I have said before, if the manufacture period is too small, then the working capital required is small. But if the length of manufacture is too long, then the working capital required is also more. Then it comes to the rate of turnover. Rate of turnover is in the sense that if the sale is faster, that is a business have a rapid turnover, then the amount of working capital required may be small. The thing is that if the production takes place today and the sale takes place faster, then the working capital required is much less. But in the case that if the production takes place today and the sale of the product is slow and the time gap required is more, then the working capital required will be more. The next factor affecting is the terms of purchase and sales. In the case of terms of purchase and sales, sometimes due to competition, the thing is that it may be necessary for the company to provide credit facility to the customers. So what happens is that if the credit facility provided to the customer is too long, that is the case that if the product is being sold in the market today and the creditors are asking for a time for 1 month for its repayment, then they will require more of the working capital. If the production the purchase and the sales requires very less time, then the working capital required is very less. Now coming to the next factor, that is the price level changes. The price level changes is about if there a variation in prices too rapidly, then the working capital required is more. But if the variation in prices does not take place, or if the variation in prices is not rapid, then the working capital required is less. Then coming to the market conditions. Market condition is depending upon the competition level. If there is more competition, we need more working capital. If there is less competition, we need less of the working capital. Now coming to the seasonality of operation. Seasonality of operation means if, for example, consider AC production. AC is required in the time of summer season, isn't it? So in that situation, what happens is that during the summer season, the production of AC will go high. At that time, we need more of the working capital. Else, during the off season time, we need less of the working capital. Then last is about the converting working assets into cash. Converting working assets into cash means if the assets of the business have liquidity, which means that if the business assets can be easily converted into cash, then less of the working capital is required. But if the business assets cannot be converted into cash, then we require more of the working capital. So this is about the capital. Hope you understood what capital is. Capital is a financial wealth which is required to start a business and also to maintain the flow of the business. There are two types of capital, fixed and the working capital. Fixed capital is for long-term purpose and required to start a production. Then working capital is for short-term purposes and it is required to maintain the flow of the production purposes. Then what we discussed is about the factors affecting working capital. In the case of factors affecting working capital, there are 8 main factors. Hope you understood everything. So thank you.